First, we will see what is silk fiber. Silk is a natural proteinic fiber and it is known as queen of the fiber. Okay, instead of being grown in the form of hair, it is produced by insects in the form of continuous fine standard strands of fibers called filament to build cocoons. There are 300 to 400 varieties of moss, but only a few pair of profitable to collect. Next is silk producing countries. Most of historians agree that silk and sericulture, the production of silk form, had their origin in China nearly to 2500 BC. Now there are over 40 countries on the world on the world map producing silk. China is the largest producer of and supplier of silk, followed by India and the Brazil. Production of silk form is called as sericulture. Types of silk. There are many types of silk, and the silk is obtained from the cocoons of certain caterpillars. They build cocoons to protect themselves. Next is the type is cultivated silk and white silk. The cultivated silk spun by Bombyx mori silkworm, and the wild spun silk was spun by species of silkworm, wild species of silkworm. Here is the structure of silk. This is cultivated silk and second one is wild silk. The cultivated silk, you can see, is little healthy than wild silk. Okay, in middle there are two, you can see the two lobes of that silk fiber. Here is the fibroin. The outer layer of that is fibroin, sericin, and the inner layers are fibroin. Okay, fibroin is a silk filament, known as silk filament. The next is, here is a silk worm life cycle. First of all, we take an adult moth. Okay, here we take together to male and female. Then they fertile and give just around 400 eggs on the mulberry leaves. And after that, we take egg on mulberry leaves in stalk, and they produce. The caterpillar eats mulberry leaves and grows bigger and bigger. It grows through the 4 months. It take 4 months. Okay, four moths on leaves. Then here is a larva. Then it will change in larva, and after larva, the caterpillar spins a cocoon of silk thread around itself. Now the larva changes in pupa after some time. It takes 18 to 20 days. Okay, the inside the cocoons, the caterpillar changes into pupa. The next is adult. Then pupa change in adult, that is called moth. And after changes in adult, the pupa release all the silk thread, means it cut the cocoon and it is came out from the cocoons. Now here is a life cycle of the sericulture silk is in detail. Now, hatching of egg. The first stage of sericulture process is the production of silkworm eggs in the controlled environmental. Environmental female moth deposits about 400 eggs at a time. Hatching of egg is normally done by spreading eggs over shallow tray. Eggs are kept in hatching shed, which is closely regulated at 80 degree Fahrenheit for about 8 to 10 days. Finally, tiny eggs are hatched into larva caterpillars. At this point, the larva is about 1/4 inch. Finally, feeding period. Once hatched, the larva are placed in huge tray and feed huge amount of chopped mulberry tree leaves. During this stage, silkworm do nothing but eat. And after about 30 or 35 days since it was hatched, it stop eating and change color to greenish white, and filled with liquid silk, and it is about 10,000 times heavier than when it hatched. The silkworm is now ready to spin a silk cocoon. Here is the spinning of the cocoon. The silkworm now starts spinning of cocoon, and liquid silk secretion extrudes from two glands, and this viscous clear liquid is forced through the openings on the mouth part of the larva, hardened and exposure to air and form transfilament. The second pair of glands nearly secretes a gummy binding fluid called salicin, which binds two filaments fibroin together steadily over the next 3 to 4 days. The silkworm rotates its body into a figure 8 movements over some 300,000 times, constructing a cocoon and producing about a mile of silk filament. Next is the caterpillar, then changes from larva to pupa, and in this condition it sleeps for about 18 to 20 days. Then it left undistributed, it transforms into moth. If pupa is not killed, it will transform into moth and becomes fully awake and strives to emerge from cocoons, and it will push itself against the wall of cocoon by breaking some of the obstructing fibers, and the continuous silk filament is thus broken up into thousands of short pieces. Within few days of making its cocoon, the silk producers kill the pupa in the cocoon. The usually method of killing are immersing the cocoon in the steam for few minutes, by baking cocoons in hot oven, and by placing the cocoons in the boiling water, and by freezing the cocoons to death. Now the process of silk fiber manufacturing process. This is first of all reeling, throwing and dehumming. In reeling, the process of unwinding the filaments from cocoon is called reeling. The process of unwinding the filament from cocoon is called reeling. This process is carried out in a building called fletcher or reeling plant, and the cocoon are soaked in boiling water to soften the sericin gum that is holding the filament in place. The cocoons are taken out and loose fluffy silk on outside is cleaned, and which is then used in production of spun silk yarn. The cocoons are again placed in hot water basin, and labor use the brushes or the brooms to push cocoon up and down in the water until some loose end of filament becomes attached to the broom. The filament is drawn out gently, and the cocoon trembles around in water and gradually unreel itself. A single filament of silk is very fine, 12 to 30 micron. The throwing. It is a process in which two or more multiple strands are combined and twisted together to form heavier threads. Now dehumming. Dehumming is a process of removing sericin from raw silk or thrown silk is called dehumming. The natural sericin gum is normally left on silk during reeling and throwing and weaving. It acts as a size which protects the filament and fibers from mechanical injury, and the gum is removed from finished yarn by boiling with salt, soap and water. Silk fabric was woven with sericin have a characteristic stiffness of handle and dull in appearance. After dehumming, silk acquire beautiful luster, and 1/3 of weight of fabric is lost when sericin gum is removed in this way. Raw silk with gum still on filament is called hard silk. Spun silk. Spun silk is a short length of silk fibers obtained from the various silk waste, are not used in real silk in making thrown silk yarn, but these are spun into yarns like cotton, linen and wool yarns. Spun silk yarn are used are strong, but they are less lustrous than reeled silk yarn, and not strong and elastic like reeled silk yarns. Here is a microscopic structure of silk threads. The silk longitudinal view of silk threads is rod-like structure, and cross-sectional view of silk fiber is triangle. And this is very straight. Now the properties of silk fiber. Tensile strength of silk is, silk is a strong fiber. Its strength is due to the linear structure and very crystalline polymer, usually 30.9 to 44.1 cm per tex. Elongation, silk filament has elongation at break 20 to 25%. Specific gravity, its specific gravity is 1.25. Gravity. सर ये हैंग हो गया है. Plastic properties. Silk is considered to be more plastic than elastic because its crystalline polymer is, it does not allow polymer movement which could only occur in amorphous region. Its handle is regarded as soft because of smooth, even and regular surface of silk filament. Effect of moisture, it absorbs moisture. Its moisture regain is 11%, and degummed silk will swell is it takes up moisture. Effect of heat, silk will withstand higher temperature of 140 degree centigrade and decompose at 165 degree centigrade. Effect of age, silk may suffer a gradual loss of strength and it stored not carefully. Effect of sunlight, silk start decomposition by exposure to sun, to strong radiation of sunlight. Effect of acid, dilute acid should be used. Effect of alkalis, light alkali like ammonia cause little damage. Effect of insects, it can be readily attacked by cloths, moths or carpet beetles. Effect of microorganisms, silk is resistant to mildew and bacteria unless it is left for some period of time under extreme conditions. Advantages of silk fabric, luxurious hand, the feel of a fiber, yarn or fabric to the wearer. Excellent drape, a fabric's ability to fold while worn. Wonderful luster, reflection of light on the fabric, and hydrophilic, strain resistant, strong wood, lightweight. Disadvantages of silk fabric, fair abrasion and resiliency, turn yellow if bleached, poor resistance to exposure sunlight, expensive and degrades over time with exposure to oxygen, making it difficult to perceive. Now the application of silk fiber. Here next is dietary, pharmaceutical, biomedical, cosmetics, automobiles, house buildings and antibacterial properties of silk fiber.